Texture Innovation Center here in White Marsh, Maryland. I'm Harold Nickel, this is Maureen Akins, and we're back for another edition of Does This Have Gum In It? Now, in the old days, when I was growing up, ice cream was a summertime thing, but it's year-round. This is delicious. And Maureen, of course, as always, does ice cream have gum in it?
Absolutely. It's very difficult in this day and age where you have mass shipping, all sorts of different temperature conditions, to not have something in there to give your ice crystals a bit of help.
Okay, let's focus on ice crystals and water management.
Yes.
Because, of course, we all know that ice cream has a lot of dairy in it. This is chocolate ice cream, so it has inclusions. But I notice when I keep ice cream around too long, it it gets frosty on top.
It can. So that's a defect in ice cream. So hopefully if you've stabilized it correctly, you don't see that. You find that very commonly in ice cream formulations that tend to have a minimal amount of stabilizers. Essentially what's happening is any ice cream, regardless of where you keep it, even the best conditions, is going to go through something we call freeze-thaw cycling. And that means the water that's inherent in the milk that's used to make the ice cream goes through phase changes. Some of those ice crystals are going to be frozen, and as the temperature changes, they will start to thaw. And as you start to lose that water from its ice crystal form into its liquid form, it can migrate. And that migration of water to the surface is what you're calling that frost on the top.
So if I understand how hydrocolloids work in general with this kind of an application, is that it keeps the water held in suspension or blended correctly? Is that a good way of looking at it?
Absolutely. So essentially what you're doing when you add a stabilizer, something that's a very good water binder like gums, it's going to be able to hold onto that water and keep it in very small pockets. So when the temperature does go down and it freezes again, it's actually going to freeze back into a very small ice crystal. And that's what you get when you have something that is freeze-thaw stable. It's the ability to keep that water, even if it melts, into a very small area so that when it freezes again, it freezes into a small piece and not a big, large ice crystal.
Now, Maureen, ice cream in a bowl or on a cone like this, that's not the only frozen treat that we enjoy year-round.
Thankfully not.
Yeah, I feel the same way. But juice bars and different kinds of frozen treats on a stick or in a bowl, do we help manage moisture with those as well?
Absolutely. And when you move into areas that are non-dairy based and that have low pH environments, you have to consider that when you're choosing your stabilizing system. So for the most part, in juice bars, you're going to use something like pectin. That's very stable at low conditions, low pH conditions, and that's going to give you that water management that you desire, along with the stability in a pH condition that's a little bit more harsh than what you find in a dairy-based ice cream type formula.
For consumers, is there any way they can know when they're at the store that this is a better quality ice cream that's going to stay in my freezer better, longer? Things on the label we should look for?
When you're looking for high quality ice cream products, there's a couple of areas that you pay attention to. First, that you're going to look for the quantity of fat, because always the more fat you have in the ice cream, the more stable it's going to be, the higher quality it's going to be.
Awesome.
But fat is not the only thing that will stabilize an ice cream. So another area to pay attention to when you're looking at labels for a ice cream type formula to make sure it's going to be stable for the long haul during freeze-thaw cycling, look for things that contain guar, locust bean gum, tarragum. Those are all very common ingredients that you're going to find because they're excellent water binders and they're going to be able to manage that ice crystal growth during phase change.
So when I'm at the store this coming weekend, I'm going to look for ice cream that has a lot of fat and one of these hydrocolloids that you just mentioned.
That's right.
So when we have our ice cream at home, obviously the temperature in the room goes up. Some ice cream gets watery and soupy very quickly. Are there things manufacturers can do with hydrocolloids to manage how quickly it melts?
You can. So one of the things that you can do is increase the stability of those ice crystals by adding some type of fortification with a gum. The last thing you want in the summertime is to have an ice cream cone and have it melting all over your hand before you get a chance to eat it. And one of the areas that has really been a focus for stabilization in terms of temperature are in the novelties area. Things that get sold at ice cream trucks and areas, you know, parks in the summertime when it's really hot. So again, the addition of things like CMC, guar gum, locust bean gum, they're going to help delay that melt so you get longer eating temperature out of a frozen dessert.
So we've learned about ice cream, the fact that it has gum in it, and what the benefits are for manufacturers and for people like me who just like ice cream. I'm gonna go eat this. In the meantime, be sure to visit our website to ask a question about ice cream or any other kind of hydrocolloid stabilization or texture question you might have. Till next month, here at the Texture Innovation Center, I'm Harold Nickel with my colleague Maureen Aikens. Thanks for watching.